Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject Internal Combustion Engine. And this is lecture number 7 on Internal Combustion Engine. And we are going to discuss about the fuel supply system in the CI engine. So, fuel supply system in the combustion ignition engine, that is diesel engine. So, we recap from the earlier lectures. So, in the earlier lecture, we studied about the fuel and the combustion in the IC engine, various types of fuel, fuel rating, calorific value, the CT number, octane number, and the fuel supply system in the SI engine. We studied about the carburetor and working of a simple carburetor and requirement of fuel supply system in the SI engine. And in this lecture, so we are going to study about the fuel supply system in the CI engine, compression ignition engine or diesel engine, and the various topics of what we are going to discuss. One is the fuel injection system, second the fuel injection pump, third the fuel injector, and fourth the quantity of fuel supplied to the diesel engine. How to measure or calculate the amount of fuel supplied during the injection period. And the learning outcome to the student at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to state the requirement of fuel injection system, and the student will be able to explain the fuel injection system, and the student will be able to discuss the construction working of fuel injection pump, and the student will be able to describe the working of the fuel injector. So there are various types of fuel injector, so they will be student will be able to discuss or describe over the fuel injector. The fuel supply system is different from the petrol engine. So, in the case of petrol engine, the air fuel mixture is prepared in the carburetor, and the air fuel mixture is admitted into the engine cylinder during the suction stroke, during the suction operation. Whereas, in the case of diesel engine or compression ignition engine, the fuel is injected. So, during the suction stroke, only the air is inducted, air is drawn into the engine cylinder during the suction stroke, and at the end of the compression stroke, so the air is only compressed in the diesel engine. At the end of the compression stroke, a small quantity of fuel is injected. So, the fuel injection, it is sprayed, it is in the atomized form. Using the temperature of the compressed air, the fuel starts to burn, the diesel starts to burn. That is why it is called as compression ignition engine. And because we are compressing only the air, so the compression ratio of the diesel engine, it is very high, more than 12 to 22. So, it is around 12 to 22 in the case of diesel engine, whereas in the case of petrol engine, it is 6 to 12. So, when you compress the air alone to a higher compression ratio in the case of diesel engine, the power produced by the diesel engine will be very high. So, comparing with the petrol engine, the power produced by the diesel engine is more. So, that is why for all heavy duty applications, we are using the diesel engine or the compression ignition engine. So, the fuel supply system of the CI engine, so the fuel injection system is the most vital component in the working of the CI engine. The engine performance is greatly dependent on the effectiveness of fuel injection system. So, how effectively the fuel is injected, because the combustion of the fuel depends on how the fuel is injected. The injection system has to perform the important duty of initiating and controlling the combustion process. So, the injection system, correct quantity of fuel is to be injected at correct time and in correct pattern, so that there will be it has to initiate the combustion and control the combustion process. So, look at the diagram. So, this is the basic diagram of the fuel injection system in the diesel engine. You take few seconds and look at the diagram, identify the component in the diagram. So, starting from the fuel tank, so this is the place where we store the required quantity of fuel. So, from the fuel tank, the fuel goes to the coarse filter. So, it is a filter, it is normally remove the unwanted impurities in the fuel. So, your pure diesel will go to the plunger feed pump. So, it is just a feed pump. So it is feeding, it is just circulating the fuel to the entire system. So the feed pump will push the fuel to the fine filter. There is another filter called the fine filter. So in the from the fine filter, it is filtered here. From the fine filter, the fuel goes to the fuel injection pump. So this is fuel injection pump. So the depending on the number of injector, number of cylinder, so there will be number of injection hole. So this is the it is raising the pressure of the fuel. So normally the fuel is injected in the case of diesel engine at 200 times the atmospheric pressure, 200 bar. So the main purpose of the fuel injection pump is to raise the pressure of the fuel from atmospheric pressure to 200 times 200 bar. So the high pressure fuel, then it goes to the fuel injector. So where using the high pressure, the use at this high pressure, the fuel is injected into the engine cylinder. So this is the this nozzle will open when the pressure is very high, 200 bar, and this fuel is given to the fuel is sprayed in the compression chamber of the engine. And the other diagram, so look at the fine filter. So in the fine filter, there is a pressure relief valve. So when the when the pressure inside the filter is higher, so the pressure relief valve will open and the excess fuel will come to the fuel tank. And here again in the injector, so the fuel is coming to the fuel injector, the fuel is injected, so there will be some quantity of excess quantity of fuel. The excess quantity of fuel will come back to the fine filter, then to the fuel tank. So there are two pumps here, one is the plunger feed pump, another one is fuel pump. So plunger feed pump, it is just circulating the fuel from the fuel tank to the fuel injection pump via the two filter, coarse filter and the fine filter. The fuel injection pump, it is raising the pressure to 200 times the atmospheric pressure. So and it is giving the high pressure fuel to the fuel injector. So at this pressure, the fuel is injected into the compression chamber of the engine. So we study about the component fuel injector, fuel injection pump in detail in the following slides. So for proper running and better performance of the engine, the fuel injection system must meet the following requirements. So what are all the requirements for the fuel injection system in the case of diesel engine? Accurate metering of fuel injected per cycle, that is correct quantity of fuel injected into the cycle. Timing the injection of fuel correctly in the cycle. So the correct time, so 5 degree before the top dead center. At the end of the compression stroke, normally the injection starts 5 degree before the top dead center and it is completed some 15 degree or 20 degree after the top dead center. Proper control of rate of injection so that the desired heat release pattern is achieved during the combustion. So rate of injection, so what is the quantity of the fuel injected per second or per crank angle, that is what the rate of injection, and the rate of injection should be uniform. So from the start of the injection till the complete of injection, the rate of injection should be constant so that we will get a better heat release pattern during the combustion process. Proper atomization of the fuel into very fine droplet. So the nozzle, the fuel injector nozzle is playing very crucial role. The nozzle will spray the fuel in the form of atoms. So using the high pressure nozzle, so high pressure fuel will be injected in the atomized form. Proper spray pattern, how the fuel is injected, it is in the form of automobile atoms all right, but it is the pattern, so it should spread the entire combustion chamber. So proper spray pattern to ensure rapid mixing of the fuel and the air and uniform distribution of the fuel throughout the combustion chamber. So that is also requirement to supply equal quantity of injection in the case of multi-cylinder engine. So when you have multi-cylinder engine, equal quantity of fuel should be injected in every cylinder. So the fuel injection system, the main part is atomization of the fuel, proper mixing of the air and the fuel, uniform distribution of the fuel throughout the combustion chamber, and in the case of multi-cylinder engine, equal quantity of fuel supplied to every cylinder. So a fuel injection system should take care of all the job. So the requirement of fuel injection system, these are all the requirement of fuel injection system in the case of diesel engine. And the fuel injection system used in the CI engine, it is two types. It is classified into two types. One is air injection system, another one is solid injection system. So we will study both the air injection system and the solid injection system in detail. air injection system. So this system is not used nowadays. Here the forced air, so the fuel is forced into the cylinder by means of compressed air. So before entering, fuel is supplied with the fuel is supplied into the engine cylinder with the help of compressed air. So this system is little used nowadays because it requires a bulky multi-stage compressor. So we have to produce high pressure air. That high using the high pressure air, the fuel is injected into the engine cylinder. So this causes increase in the engine weight and reduces the brake power output. So because of the additional component called multi-stage compressor, the weight of the engine will increase and the power output for further use will reduce. So one advantage of this type is good mixing of air and the fuel, because the fuel is injected already mixed with the compressed air, and using that compressed air it is supplied to the engine cylinder. So there is better mixing of air and the fuel, so the power produced will be combustion will be better. Another advantage is the ability to utilize the fuel of higher viscosity, because we are using the air for injection, so fuel with the higher viscosity can be used. So now this is not used, this is not economical methodology nowadays, we are not using it. So we are using only solid injection system, where the fuel is directly injected into the combustion chamber without an aid of the compressed air. So in this system, the fuel is directly injected into the combustion chamber without the aid of compressed air. The system is further classified into four types: individual pump and nozzle system, unit injector system, common rail system, and distributor system. So the solid injection system, so it is injecting the fuel directly into the combustion chamber at the end of the compression stroke. So there are four types, so we will see one by one. So this is the first type, individual pump and nozzle system. So look at the diagram, there are two diagram for this individual pump and nozzle system. So look at the diagram for few seconds. So here we have the LP pump. So fuel is supplied by the LP pump, and the fuel from the LP pump is taken to the HP pump. So the HP pump is the high pressure pump, LP pump is the low pressure pump. It is just circulating, and here the required injection pressure is created by the HP pump. So from the HP pump, the fuel is given to the injector. So this is the cylinder head, there are two cylinders. So HP pump, this HP pump is supplying the fuel to the injector, and this HP pump supplies the fuel to the another injector. So this line is called as high pressure line, and this is called as low pressure line. Normally when you look at the diesel engine, bus or the tractor or automobile, the high pressure line is metal pipe, because higher pressure, so it is used metal pipes are used for high pressure line, and the low pressure line they are PVC small plastic pipes. And here we have another layout for the individual pump and nozzle system. Here the two pumps are arranged, this is called as clustering of the pump. So two pumps are attached, so the fuel comes into the pump, and again the operation is the same. There are two pumps in a cluster form, and this first pump is supplying the fuel to the first injector, and the second pump supplies the fuel to the second injector. So in this system, each cylinder is provided with one pump and one injector. So for every cylinder, suppose you have six cylinder engine, there will be six pumps and six injector. So in this arrangement, a separate metering and the compression pump is provided for each cylinder. So the pump may be placed close to the cylinder. So this is close to the cylinder, or they may be arranged in a cluster. So this is the cluster form. The plunger of high pressure pump is actuated by the cam and produces a fuel necessary to open the injector valve at the correct timing. The amount of fuel injected depending on the effective stroke of the plunger. So the plunger pump, the stroke of the plunger pump that regulate the quantity of the fuel supplied to the engine cylinder. So this is the individual pump and the nozzle system. And second one is unit injector system. So look at the diagram here. So here again, for every cylinder we have a separate pump and the injector, but in this system, the pump and the injector nozzle are combined in one housing. So here we have the pump and injector. So the LP pump, it is supplying the fuel. So this is called as low pressure line, LP, low pressure pump and low pressure line. So the low pressure fuel is taken to the the pump and the injector unit. So they are in a single housing, and the first fuel enters into the pump, it is getting pressurized, and then the fuel is injected into the combustion chamber through the nozzle. So each cylinder is provided with one of these unit injector. The fuel is brought up to the injector by the low pressure pump. At the correct time, the rocker arm actuates the plunger and thus injects the fuel into the engine cylinder. The amount of fuel injected, again, it is regulated by the effective stroke of the plunger. So the stroke, the movement of the plunger in the fuel pump, that is what regulating, that is what metering the amount of fuel into the supplied to the engine cylinder. And this is the common rail system. The fourth system is common rail system. And look at the diagram. So here, so again it is a two cylinder engine. We have a header, high pressure header. So we have only one pump and we have a header. So the high pressure pump is producing high pressure fuel, and the high pressure fuel is available in a header. So this is called as common rail. So here we have the high pressure fuel. So the high pressure fuel from the header is taken to the engine injector, so fuel injector. So depending on the timing of injection, so the fuel will be injected into the engine cylinder in a particular cylinder. So for example, injection the first cylinder and injection the second cylinder according to the requirement. For example, for the first cylinder, maybe suction starts on the here, it is little later. So the timing of injection will be different for different cylinder, and at the correct time, the high pressure fuel will be injected into the cylinder. So there is an advantage here in the common rail system. We require only a single pump. So the single pump will pressurize the fuel, and the pressurized fuel will be available on the line, and this fuel will be utilized by the injector at required time. So in the common rail system, a HP pump supply fuel under high pressure to the fuel header. So from the header, the fuel supplied to the individual cylinder through the pipes. The amount of fuel entering into the cylinder is regulated by the varying length of the push rod mechanism. So we have a push rod arrangement for regulating the amount of fuel supplied to a particular cylinder. So this is very popular. Common rail system is very popular in the multi-cylinder engine, like truck or tractor or heavy duty vehicle, multi-cylinder diesel vehicle. We are using only common rail system where we have only a single pump. And the distributor system. So in this system, the pump which pressurizes the fuel also meters and times it. The fuel pump after metering the required amount of fuel, supply it to a rotating distributor at the correct time for the supply of each cylinder. So look at here, we have a bevel gear mechanism which has a distributor. So the fuel from the low pressure fuel from the from outside, it is entering to the pump. So it is pressurizing, and the fuel is supplied to the distributor. So the distributor will distribute and meter the fuel. So it will regulate the quantity as well as the timing of the injection in a particular cylinder. So this is the distributor which is supplying the fuel to a particular cylinder. For example, first cylinder and this is the second cylinder. So high pressure fuel is taken from the distributor to the injector. So this is the distributor system. So there are four methods. So unit injection, individual pump and nozzle system, and unit injector system where the pump and the injector are clubbed together in a single housing, and the common rail system where we have only one pump and which supply the fuel to the header, and from the header the fuel is given to the injector, and this is the distributor system where we have pump and the distributor. So the distributor will distribute the fuel to a particular cylinder at required timing. So these are all the four different types of fuel supply system in the CI engine, fuel injection system in the CI engine. Then in all the system, we have one component called fuel injection pump. So the main purpose of the objective of the fuel injection pump is to deliver accurately metered quantity of fuel under high pressure at the correct instant to the injector fitted on the cylinder. So accurately metering, that is accurately measuring the quantity of the fuel injected and pressurizing the fuel. There are two activities, increasing the pressure as well as regulating the quantity of the fuel injected to a particular cylinder. So these two activities are done by the fuel injection pump. The fuel injection pump, there are two types, jerk type of pump and distributed type of pump. So we will see one by one. This is the jerk type of pump. So look at the diagram for few seconds, identify the components. I will explain how the pump is working. Okay, so the main component, so the plunger is the main component. The top of the plunger, so this is the entire unit is the plunger. The top, how the plunger is looking like, so look at this diagram. This is the plunger and this is the barrel. So here we have the plunger and the barrel. So top of the plunger, so we have a helical groove. So this slot is called as helical groove. And this is the top surface of the plunger. Here we have a small opening and this opening is connected to the helical groove on the plunger's body. So this is again the helical groove. This is one angle, this is another angle. And in the barrel, we have the two opening. There are two opening. So this is, first, this is the fuel inlet line. This is the fuel inlet line. So from the fuel inlet, so this is the fuel sump. And from the fuel sump, we have the intake port. So, small opening is called as intake port. And this port is called as spill port. So, intake port and the spill port. Then, so this is the chamber. So, where the fuel is getting injected. And this plunger, there are two movement available for the plunger. One is the vertical movement, up and down movement. The up and down movement is provided by the cam. So, here look at the... Actually, we have a spring attached to the plunger, so which will retain. So, against the spring pressure only, we have to move the plunger. So, the plunger here, this cam is actuating the plunger. When the cam pushes the plunger will move in the upward direction. When the cam force is removed, automatically using the spring pressure, the plunger will come back to the original position. So, the original position of the plunger. And we have, so this is the up and down movement. Up and down movement is given by the cam of the engine, cam shaft and the cam. And we have another movement, right? The control rack. So, the control rack is actually regulating the quantity of the fuel and the plunger movement, upward movement, it is pressurizing the fuel. So, the control rack, it will make the plunger to rotate about the axis of the plunger. So, look at the plunger here. So, this is one angle, this is another angle, and when the, actually the two movement, so one is the slight tilting action is done by the rack, and the up and down movement is given by the cam mechanism. And here we have the spring, and this opening is to the injector. So, from here the fuel is supplied to the injector. So, through this opening, the high pressure fuel is leaving the pump. So, here again we have the delivery valve and again a delivery valve spring. When the fuel is delivered with a higher pressure, so the delivery valve will open and the fuel will go to the injector. When the fuel injection is completed, automatically the spring will close the valve. So, always it is in the closed position. When the pressure of the fuel is higher than the spring pressure, the spring force, spring pressure is giving a force in the downward direction, the fuel pressure is giving the upward direction, a force in the upward direction. When this, the fuel force is higher, the valve will open and the fuel will go to the fuel injector. So, how it works? How the entire pump is working? Now, look at here. This is the initial position. Now, the intake port is open. The fuel will enter into the chamber above the plunger. So, fuel will enter into the chamber and look at here. The spill port is closed by the surface of the piston, surface of the plunger. So, once the fuel is supplied to the chamber, the above the top surface of the plunger will move in the upward direction. When the plunger is moving in the upward direction, so here the fuel is getting compressed. So, the pressure of the fuel is increasing. When the pressure is sufficient for injection, that is I said 200 bar, when the pressure is sufficient for injection, so, this valve will open and the excess fuel and the fuel with the higher pressure will go to the injector. So, the plunger movement, it continues in the upward direction. So when at a particular moment as the injection proceeds, so this rack will move and it will make the plunger to tilt. When the plunger is tilting, so look at here, the helical portion will have in contact with this spill port. So the helical portion will have in contact with the spill port. So the spill port here, the pressure is low pressure. So the pressure inside, the pressure of the fuel will suddenly decrease. Automatically the injector, so the delivery valve will be closed and the excess fuel will leave from the spill port and the plunger will come down. So the in the upward stroke, the through the intake port, the fuel is coming to the pressure, I mean the cylinder, and it is compressed by the piston plunger upward movement, and once the fuel is injected, the rack will tilt the plunger and the tilting action will have the exposure to the spill port. So through the spill port, when the fuel is exposed to the spill port, the pressure in the chamber, pressure in the cylinder will decrease, and the delivery valve will be closed and the plunger will be returning to the original position, and again the cam will actuate the plunger in the upward direction. So the two movement, upward movement and downward movement of the plunger is actuated by the cam, and the tilting action is done by the spill, I mean the control rack. And there is another type of pump, distributed type of pump. In the distributed type of pump, again we have the plunger system. So we have two plungers here. So here the plungers are moving away and here the plungers are moving closer towards the center. So we have a rotor, so which will be able to rotate about the axis, and we have the inlet side and the delivery side. So when the plunger is moving away, so the fuel line, so this rotor will have in contact with the intake line, and the fuel will be coming to the plunger, so to the cylinder. Then the rotor is rotating about the axis, about the vertical axis, and when the plunger, they are moving towards the center, towards the axis, so the fuel in the line, it is getting compressed, and at the same time, the rotor will have the contact with the port B, that is outlet port, and through this outlet port, the high pressure fuel will go to the engine cylinder. So the front view elevation and the top view of the two rotor. So the first position exposed to the inlet valve, and the second position the exposed to the outlet. So the fuel will, from the outlet, it will go to the fuel injection, a fuel injector. So this is the distributed type of pump. Normally we are using the jerk type of pump in automobile for all the high heavy duty vehicle for our use. So this is what the pump we are very popular in the automobile. And this is the fuel injector. So this is what the simplified diagram of the fuel injection pump. So we have a cam, roller tablet and the plunger movement, and we have the spill port, this is the intake port, and the fuel, here we have the delivery valve. So through the delivery valve, the fuel will be supplied to the fuel injector. So the fuel from the delivery pump, it is coming here, and here we have a nozzle, everything, and through the nozzle, the fuel is injected into the engine cylinder. And this is the fuel injector. So this is the construction, cross section of the injector. So here again, we have the nozzle body, and this portion, nozzle body is, actually there will be screw here, and the screw will be attached to the engine cylinder, cylinder head. So cylinder head, this portion, screw portion is injected into the cylinder head, and this line will be matching with the engine cylinder head, and here again we have a spindle, a spring and adjusting screw and leak off line, and fuel from the fuel pump. So fuel from the fuel pump will come to the line and it will flow here, and here we have the plunger, once again nozzle valve we have, and we have a spindle. So when the pressure in the fuel line, fuel passage is very high, so this nozzle valve will open against the spring force. So what is the duty of the spring? The spring always keep the spindle move downward and close the valve. When the pressure is higher than the spring pressure, automatically the valve will be lifted and the fuel will be injected or sprayed into the combustion chamber. So the nozzle, here the very important component is the fuel nozzle. So we said atomization, proper spray pattern and mixing of air and fuel, all the three. The main combustion of the fuel, it is governed by the spray pattern, how the fuel is injected into the engine cylinder, that is due to the nozzle, the proper design of the nozzle. And fuel injection nozzle, So nozzle is that part of the injector through which the liquid fuel is sprayed into the combustion chamber, and nozzle should fulfill the following functions: atomization, distribution of the fuel, prevention of impingement on the wall, and mixing the fuel and the air in the case of non-turbulent type of combustion chamber should be taken care by the nozzle. So the fuel injection nozzle is playing a crucial role in the CI engine in the fuel injection as well as combustion. So the efficient combustion of the fuel depends on the position and design of the fuel injection nozzle. So the nozzle should fulfill the following conditions. One is atomization. In this is very important function since it is the first phase of obtaining proper mixing of fuel and air in the combustion. So proper mixing of air and fuel is very important in the case of diesel engine combustion. So the fuel supply system, particularly nozzle, right, the fuel should be injected in the atomized form. So the atomization of the fuel is done by the nozzle. Then distribution of the fuel. The distribution of the fuel is require the areas with the combustion chamber. So the entire area, so we have to distribute the fuel to the entire area of the combustion chamber. So factor affecting this: injection pressure, density of the air, and the physical property of the fuel. So the distribution of the fuel. So it is pressurized fuel. So higher the injection pressure, the distribution will be better. But at the same time, it should not. The third point is important: prevention of impingement on the wall. So more the injection pressure, the fuel spray it will reach the wall. So you should not, the fuel particle should not touch the combustion chamber wall. That is also very important. When it is touching the combustion chamber wall, it is only wastage of fuel. It is not in the combustion, it will become waste. So prevention of fuel from the impinging directly on the wall of the combustion chamber or the piston surface. So the fuel particle should not impinge on the combustion chamber cylinder wall or piston stop surface. So this is necessary because fuel sticking on the wall decomposes and produces carbon deposits on the surface. So it is not part, it is not burning, it is decomposing. So this causes smoky exhaust as well as increase in the fuel consumption. Then mixing. So the proper mixing of air and fuel in the case of non-turbulent type of combustion chamber. So this is also important. So atomization, distribution of the fuel, prevention of impingement on the wall, and mixing of the air and the fuel in the combustion chamber. All the four activities, they are governed by the nozzle, fuel injection nozzle. So fuel injection nozzle, it plays a crucial role in the combustion of fuel in the CI engine. And there are different types of nozzle used: pintle nozzle, single hole nozzle, multi hole nozzle, and pintox nozzle. So look at the diagram of all the four types of nozzle. We take a few seconds and look at the diagram. So in every nozzle, we have a nozzle body, and this is the nozzle valve, and we have a fuel supply line. In the pintle hole nozzle, so we have a small piston like arrangement which will close the opening. So when the high pressure fuel is entering here, so the nozzle valve will be lifted up and the fuel will be sprayed into the engine cylinder. So here, so it is in the form of cone. So the fuel will be injected in the form of cone. The cone angle, spray cone angle, is around 60 degree in the case of pintle hole nozzle. And single hole nozzle, we have a valve here, once again a conical type of valve here, and it is closing the small hole. The diameter of the hole is around 0.2 millimeter. The spray cone angle here, it is 15 degrees. So this in the case of single hole nozzle, the spray cone angle, so here it is 60 degree and here it is only 15 degree, and this hole is triple. Actually the fuel will leak, instead of spraying, it is tripling from the opening, and this is normally not preferred. Either we are preferring the spindle hole or multi hole nozzle. So in the multi hole nozzle, we have number of holes, so 4 to 18. Number of holes around the body is 4 to 18, and the diameter will be 35 micrometer to 200 micrometer, and the cone angle of spray is 20 degree. So there will be multiple hole, so the distribution will be better, atomization will be better in the case of multi-hole nozzle. And this is Pintax nozzle. So there are two opening here, one is axillary hole, another one is main opening. So here again, before the main injection, through the axillary hole, a small quantity of fuel will be supplied, and then in the main injection, the remaining quantity is injected. So this will again give the better mixing or better distribution of the fuel into the combustion chamber. So pintle hole, single hole, multi hole, and Pintax nozzle, these are all the four different types of nozzles used in the injection nozzles used in the diesel engine. And the quantity of fuel injected, so the quantity of fuel injected per cycle is Q equal to pi by 4 d square into n. Pi by d is the diameter of the orifice, n is the number of holes in the orifice, vf is the velocity of the fuel, theta is the duration of fuel injection. So I said normally this is 40 degree of crank angle, theta equal to 40 degree of crank angle, and n is the speed of the engine, and ni is the number of injection per minute. So in the case of two stroke cycle engine, ni equal to n, and in the case of four stroke cycle engine, ni equal to n divided by 2. So pi by 4 d square into n, total area, velocity, and the time, so the speed. So this is what the quantity of fuel injected, and this, remember, this theta equal to maximum of 40 degree of crank angle, and other number of holes, diameter, everything numerical, actually these are all the design parameter, and n is the speed of the engine. So here theta is crucial, the angle of injection roughly 40 degree of crank angle. So we stop here. So we have a reflection spot, we have to answer a few questions from the lecture. A very simple question, write down the names of the topic which you are very clearly understood from the lecture. So here we took a little more extra time. So all the topic in the fuel supply system in the CA engine we have covered. You write down the topic, what all you remember in your mind. So fuel injection system, jerk type of fuel injection pump, distributed type of fuel injection pump, fuel injector, fuel injection nozzle. So these are all the topics we studied, and try to read the lecture notes, and try to understand the working construction, the working of the pump and the fuel injector and the fuel nozzle. So these are all the reference book I used for preparing this aid. You can also refer to it. I have published a book on thermal engineering. You can refer to it. There are other internal combustion engine books. You can also refer to it for additional information. And thank you for watching. So please post your comment on the comment box of YouTube. You subscribe the channel. I have uploaded more than 160 videos on the thermal engineering subject, like thermodynamics, heat and mass transfer. And I have uploaded the solution for the gate question paper also in the YouTube video. So you can listen to it for your better learning, and you can write to my mail ID for any queries or clarification, or WhatsApp to this number. I will sincerely answer. So thank you very much. We'll meet again.